Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to DCI Last Alliance. I would actually like to play a third campaign on this channel, and I have been looking towards the Kingdom of Khazad-Dûm. I would love to play some dwarves, so that's what I'm gonna do. Without further ado, let's jump into the campaign. I will muster a legion fully armed and filthy. That's what I'm gonna do. Let's see here what we have to deal with in the start here. The Balrog, I'm not so keen on this one. I'm probably thinking no thank you on that one. I'm sorry, Balrog, but I'm gonna decline you. I'm a scared little man. Nazgul, fine. That's okay. Let's see. We have a splitted realm here. Khazad-Dûm is governed by our king, Durin. Let's see what he has for bodyguard. Dwarven nobleman. 30 in attack and 30 defense. Effective against armor. He will be a beast. And Burin over here has Dwarven Nobleman as well. Let's see, to the west here we have Busra-Dûm over here. Captain Farin, you could actually jump into the settlement instantly. And we have Narg-Dûm over here in the west, with Frar and some Nogrod raiders here, and he has Firebeard Nobleman. 30 in attack, 31 defense. An excellent melee force. Gamil of Eredluin. Let's see what you have. Broadbeam Nobleman. 14 attack, 21 defense. Oof, effective against armor as well. Some sturdy looking dwarfs right there. Also have some Eredluin Wardens over here and some minor militia. Screeching Dismay's enemy. I have no idea what this does. If someone would like to explain it for me, please do in the comment section. And over here at the east we have Iron Hills. Fundin of the Iron Hills. Dwarven Nobleman, the regular bodyguard, and Lord Regin, with some Dwarven Noblemen as well. Okay, let's start off with Khazad-Dûm here. Very expensive with the mines, but it would let us gain some gold pretty fast. Let's see here. I think I actually might. Let's see our culture here. 80%. Okay, so we're safe in the culture department. Let's actually then build me a market here. What can we recruit here? We can recruit Durin's Chosen. Effective against armor, 13 attack, 31 defense. These guys will be beastly. 400 upkeep though. They will be expensive to maintain. Do we have any agents nearby? Let's see if we do. We have a spy. Oh, he's over here. Yeah, some small goblin forces over there. Let's keep heading up here in the hills. And let's build something here in Narg-Dûm. Grocery import or mines. I would like to afford something in the other settlements as well, so I'm gonna go with the grocery import for the moment. And let's see here in Busra-Dûm. Barazdûm, not Busra-Dûm. I'm too used to divide and conquer. You could build me an... let's actually get this one. No, we have quite a large population here. Let's go with the pig import here. And back in the Iron Hills, I would like to get the, let's culture, 85%. Let's go with the pig import here as well. And our first mission should be to take Erebor, of course. It's a large city, so I would love to get this. That should be our first priority. And Burin over here, you can actually start building some towers over here. You can build one outside here. Nice, we'll get some vision over here. And then the faction King Durin, if you can, build one here as well. Head back. Burin, you can head over here and build me a tower here. Let's see, how long does this actually go? Oh no, don't attack. Don't attack. Okay, we have here. If you could build me a tower somewhere around here, that would be amazing. You could build me a tower over here. And then you can head back here. Lord Regin, I want you to... Oh, we cannot... You can actually start marching towards Erebor instantly. Oh, it's actually empty. I wonder if these guys will take it instantly. We will siege Erebor as soon as we can. That shall be our main priority. We are building in every settlement. Let's try and get a diplomat as well for some trade rights and some other things. If you could build me a spy actually as well on the next turn, that would be great. I would like to scout some of the rebel areas around here. Or maybe not. I will actually build a spy here because I have a spy already here in Khazad-Dûm. So I will build a spy here. And I can't afford a watchtower at the moment here. So I will not. Okay, let's see if we can actually gather a little force here. Gamil of Ered Luin, if you could actually lead a force with some Nogrod raiders and a few Ered Luin wardens. Frar could be the governor of Nargdum. That would be perfect. And you could actually start marching and scout a little bit. I think there should be a town here. Stronghold, Kibildum. I would love to capture that one. Let's march towards that one. And let's end the turn and see what happens. I'm really excited to play as the dwarves. The kingdom of Khazad-Dûm, even. It feels epic, just to say it. This will be a funny campaign. I will still continue to do videos for the other campaigns, my Men of the Mountains campaign and my Eringalen campaign. So don't be scared about that. I will keep them coming. I just couldn't wait on playing the dwarves. Erebor, yes. That's exactly where I'm headed. Let's actually get some... Oh, they're expensive. Let's see if we're gonna need... I don't think so. We have really strong spearmen here. 6 attack, 23 defense. And some veterans of the Iron Hills. Longbear, yeah. My force is strong. Let's start building some siege equipment. Oh, we actually have a rebel village here as well. You know what? You could actually recruit one of these. It's empty. And I will take this cav and just grab that really fast in the next turn. Fundin, if you could build me a tower over here somewhere. I don't want you to wander away from the Iron Hills because they're unhappy here. Is there anything that we can build? Yeah, the barracks would give us 15% in public order bonus. Let's try and build the barracks afterwards. Oh yeah. Shift F1, let's see what we have. Okay, if I lose every settlement I have, my people will still remain, so I could still capture a settlement, even though one of my cities would... Yeah, if I would be out of settlements, I could still fight on. That's good to know. Okay, so I need to be allied with the faction that calls at Tola Kharns to be part of that one. Okay, so the Khazad homelands, yes. This is one of the homeland settlements. And this is just some regular stuff. So yeah. But I don't plan to lose any settlements. I don't want to go rogue and just be a wandering people. I want to keep my settlements. If I can. The spy... the diplomat has been completed. Let's go towards Lothlorien. Yeah, I don't have any allies for the moment. So if you could actually start marching towards Lothlorien, that would be great. And Durin, you could head back to Khazad-Dûm for the moment. And over here in the west, Gamil will keep on marching towards Khibildûm. Yeah, Khibildûm. I would like you to capture that one. Frar, one little watchtower here, and you can, yeah, they're happy even though he's out. Let's just keep building watchtower with you then. Okay, we have full vision here. Or could we actually go down here? No, we cannot. Just head back then. Is there anything other that I can do on this turn? Do I have any siege equipment? No, not yet. Let's end the turn again. There we have Goblin Town, a settlement I would love to get. I would love to control the whole mountain area around here. To wipe the goblins out of the picture and just control the entirety of this mountain regions over here. Let's go talk with Lothlorien if we can find them. Grocery import has been constructed. Pig import. I would actually love the mines here. I will save for them. You can head back to the settlement. Agent spy. No settlement around here. You can actually start going there because we are going here. And Burin over here. If you could build me a tower. Yeah, this is a perfect spot. And it seems we are not having any rebel settlement around here. So the first thing we shall do from Khazad-Dûm is to march towards this one. Imbargathol. And try and capture that one. Burin, you will be the governor of Khazad-Dûm. I would like to see my king in action. Number 3 upkeep units, 5. That's quite good. Let's get some archers. Let's actually go. No, we will wait for a turn. I need some more money. Let's wait a little while. And let's see if we can charge these buggers down. But before I do that, I will send my cav and see if I can. No, I cannot. Well, let's capture this one and then send my cav to Dalathales and try and get that as soon as possible. Let's go into fight. The Battle of Erebor will begin. Let's go. We outclass the rebels insanely much, so this shouldn't be any problem whatsoever. The only problem it might be is if they destroy my ram. I think we won't be able to get into the settlement if they destroy it, so let's hope they do not destroy my ram. Okay, where is the entrance? Here we have, they don't even have a gate here. Oh, that's good. Let's put our force up here. And the cavalry, I don't think that you will be needed this day. You're actually ranged. You're an archer cav. Okay, well, then you might be a little bit useful then. Yeah, let's just run in. Oh, it's like a maze here. Start marching. Yeah, it seems like they have gathered everything here at the plaza. Well, we're just gonna have to kill them all, I think. I'm totally up for that. Azaghal, slightly increases combat effectiveness, decreases fatigue. That's good. We are a heavily armored nation, so I think we will be winded fast. Just see at my troops, they're already winded. Although they are marching up this hill here. Let's see if we could actually harass them a little bit with our cav. Where do we actually get in here? Let's try this way. You can start marching there. Cavalry, which way are you taking? Okay, it seems to be this way that you have to go. This settlement should be quite easily to defend, I think. If we were to be besieged here, so that's good to know. We should be able to defend this quite easy if they were to attack us somewhere. For example, Rune might come up there and attack. This is surely a maze. Can you go? Yeah, you can go here. Let's try and see if we can position ourselves somewhere that we could get some good shots in. Let's go here. Yeah, they're marching towards me. Let's go back. Let's stand here instead then. Let's march here. Okay, you're taking that way. You know what? Turn this shit off. I hate this one. The skirmish mode is... sucks. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy. Just keep on harassing them. And we're stuck here. Okay, so let's just run around here then. Where are my dwarven guys? You're over here. I would love for you to just get in here and start slaughtering them. You know what? Don't run. You will be exhausted before you have even arrived. Cavalry, if you could just keep on firing here at a peasant bowman, that would be amazing. And you're getting some kills here. That's good. They've already lost 20% of their force. Just keep on firing at them. Dwarves, where are you? You're here. Cavalry, you can actually head out of here, I think. You're soon out of ammo. Let's actually charge the archers here, if we can. I don't think they charged. Let's head out here.
Remain true and steadfast. Victory will be ours.
And let's see some dwarven men in action. Yeah, they're already insanely tired. You know what? Do a little charge before you go. Let's see if we do some damage here. No, they're not charging at all. Well, you can keep them there for the moment until my dwarves arrive. You can actually start running. So can you. Let's see. The glorious charge of the noblemen. Let's see how much damage they will do. They look badass. They look so badass. Huge axes. Yeah, prepare to be wrecked, peasant bowmen. You have no chance against the might of the dwarven noblemen. I can tell you that. Yeah, they're getting destroyed. And they are soon here. You can actually get out of here now. You have done your job. Get out of here. Oh, they are so tired already. Oh, they look so cool, these dwarven units. Let's see at the veterans here. Yeah, some two-handed dwarven man. You can actually start going here. Long-beard axeman. Yeah, dwarves are so cool. Let's annihilate these peasant archers and let's head in to the slaughter fest that will be here in the middle. Can you? Oh, you cannot go here, it seems. Or can you? No, you cannot. Okay, so we cannot move up here, it seems like. Let's go here then, instead. They have routed. Start marching in for the square. You can join them as well. Yeah, we're gonna have to kill them all here at the plaza. Well, I don't mind. My dwarves should outclass the shit out of them, so I'm not nervous. I don't want my general to die, though. That would be painful. Let's see them in action here. Yeah, they're getting wrecked so fast. Let's pop the Azaghal ability. Some epic... oh, how do you say it in English? Horn. Some epic horn sound there. From the Hobbit films. Iron Hill veterans are on their way. Let's actually just plow through here. Shouldn't be any problem. Not for these sturdy bastards. Yeah, let's just slaughter them all. The Freisvar stand no chance against my dwarves. They are getting some cheeky shots in, though, with their archers. I don't like that. If you could head down here, please. That would be lovely. Kill these archers here. Make them route perfect. And just go in a line like this. And start charging them down. Baruch Khazad! Oh, they're so tired. Head down and start killing them.
Our men are winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
If we could just run through here, could kill them a little bit faster. Yeah, they're getting destroyed so fast by my dwarves. They are so powerful, the dwarven units. As they should be. Dwarves should be heavily armored and strong in battle. Run through. Just fast forward this. It's over. We have already won. Well, although we're losing quite a lot here of the spearmen, actually. General, if you could help the spearmen out, I would be happy about that.
Ach, my lord. Our men are in control of the city.
Everyone, kill these spearmen. Yeah, they are dropping fast now. Two guys remaining. Two guys, should be two guys. Oh, we have one over there as well. Kill him. Come on. Nice, good job. He's dead as well. This dude, oh, it's the general. That's why he's not dead yet. He should die at any moment. He shouldn't be able to withstand this. There he goes. A clean victory, I think. Let's see how many dwarves that died in this battle. Well, we actually lost 144. That's not so good. But Erebor has been claimed. We are expanding our Dwarven Empire in Middle-earth. Let's see who got the most kills. Oh, the cavalry. 217. They did their job well. The Dwarven Noblemen lost 6 men and killed 158. A job well done by the Dwarven Noblemen indeed. Let's see if we could grab that other rebel settlement that was empty. Really, little cheeky move here. If we can take this one, that would be amazing. Let's see here. Yes. Occupy. Yeah, put it on low and let's get the town watch here. Or let's see what we can get in Erebor first. Get the mines here. Let's build the roads first. And let's get the... I would like to get the town watch here. Or no, maybe get the grocery import. That's the only one I can afford, so I'll go with that one. Excellent. We have captured 2 settlements in 1 turn. I'm really happy about that. Let's see. Now is the time for watchtower building. Let's just head out and build some towers. They are really expensive though, so we have to be careful. Oh, and here we have Eskaroth as well. Which is a port settlement. That would be good for income. But for the moment, let's just keep getting some towers up. You could actually head back here. And I believe we're at an end turn, so let's end the turn. It seems we're already bordering Rune. They might come with a force to try and attack us over in the east. Let's see if we could... Where are they? Where is their... settlement. I would like to see that. Yeah, the barracks event thing. Well, we cannot afford to... Well, how many units do you want? 4 units. How many units can we spare from here? Well, let's ignore that mission then. It's not a priority. Tower building is, though, so let's keep building towers around here. Pig import has been constructed here. Let's go for the public house here. Wait, let's not build anything here. This is the least important settlement for the moment. Let's see if we can get some... I would love to get some mining going, because we're gonna need it. We are an expensive nation to uphold, so a few mines here and there would be good for us to get. But we can't afford anything. Let's see if we could get some other things that's good for economy. I'm gonna queue the mines up. I would love to get some mining builded somewhere. Let's see, let's queue it up here at the airport. No, we're already building roads there. Let's queue it up in the Iron Hills then instead. 833 gold. That would be insanely useful. let's see, we have you're there and you're over there. Head down here. We have another rebel settlement here, Lunilith. And it's a dwarven homeland as well. So this should be a priority to take after we take Khazad-Dûm. Yeah, you already know low tax rate. Let's actually send over these Iron Hills veterans over here to Dalathiles to make them a little bit happier. Keep building towers. Can you actually move here and build a tower over there? Yes, this is good. Keep marching around here. I would like to get the troop here as well. Let's go for some Khazad archers here. After the roads, I would like to get the tool exchange. It's cheap and it generates some money, so let's queue that up. Let's end the turn and see what happens. Oh, I forgot about the diplomats, of course. I have to remember to speak with Lothlorien when this end turn is over. I need to milk some gold from the elves. Let's see if they're willing to pay 2,000 gold. That would make me a very happy dwarf. Let's see, I shall read this. Even though Sauron returned to Middle-earth not that long ago, following the destruction of Numenor in 3319, Second Age, he has unleashed his regained power of orcs, men and beasts, to wipe out all his remaining enemies once and for all. In 3429, he surprised the Gondorians, seized Minas Ithil, and burned the White Tree. Anarion took command of Gondor, while his brother Isildur sailed north to their father, High King Elendil, in Arnor. The brothers knew that without help, Gondor would not survive. The worried Elendil discreetly communicated with his good friend Gil-galad, High King of the Noldor and the Elves of Eriador, and they have taken counsel together, wise lords as they are. They perceived that Sauron will grow too strong and overcome all his enemies one by one if they do not unite against him. Therefore, the Dúnedain and the Elves of Lindon now declare a league, which shall go down in history as the last alliance. Their military advisors start planning for a joint military operations to commence within a few years. Interesting information. Let's talk with Kerin Lori, the Lothlorien stronghold here. Alliance, trade rights, map info, and you shall give me... Let's try 1,000 gold. No. Alliance, trade rights, map info, and 1,000 gold. No. Let's just go alliance and trade rights then. Okay, trade rights then. Yes, thank you. Demanding, okay. No, let's not be allied then. Map info. And 1,000 gold. How does that sound? Yes. Thank you, elves. A little bit more gold for me. Let's head towards Mordor. Or we actually might be at war with them. No, we're not. Let's head towards Mordor then. Let's see. Which of the mines started building? Okay, the mines at Nargdum has started building, that's good. Yeah, the town watch here, we'll have to wait with that one. It's not a priority at the moment. Keep building towers over here. I don't want to be surprised by a potential Misty Mountain attack on me. So let's build towers over here. And Let's, yeah, you're already sieging there, that's good. If you could build a tower here, that would be perfect. Yeah, this is good. Now we have some sight range over here if Rune decides to attack us. Yeah, you're building the roads, that's good. I don't think we can do anything more this turn. You can head back for the moment, and let's see. I would love to try and go for this one. They only have one in garrison. Let's actually send out a force. Let's send the king. How much will we suffer economically? Okay, like 50 gold. That's fine. Longbeard Axeman, you will join and you will take the... Oh, they're so expensive, everyone. Let's take some minor militia with you as well. Start marching towards Imbargathol. And let's end the turn. Yeah, we might actually have a few battles with the Hillmen of the North as well. They're quite close to us here in the West. So we might actually fight them a few times. That's a lovely baby. Lovely beard you going there. You got there, baby? Let's see. Could we afford anything? No. Nothing has been... We will just have to wait for the mines to get constructed. We're still gaining money, so we will get there eventually. Build me a tower over here. I'm sorry for my bad English this episode. I'm a little bit tired after work, so I'm a little bit blah 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 with my words. I hope that you don't mind. And let's besiege and attack Khazad-Dûm. I would love to see these dwarves in action. But we will do that in the next episode. I hope you will be watching that one. Thank you for watching and have a lovely, lovely day, everybody. Goodbye to you all.